In season 4 of The Crown, we see Prince Charles and Princess Diana embark on their landmark royal tour of Australia and New Zealand in 1983, marking the 22-year-old princess's first ever overseas trip. In The Crown, the tour also marks Prince William's first overseas public appearance after his mother Diana.
Do you have children?
No, ma'am.
Why does that not come as a surprise?
Diana.
Come with me.
Ma'am.
Please.
Played by Emma Corrin in the Crown cast, breaks with royal tradition and insists on bringing him to Australia.
It's a beautiful child.
I'm busy, ma'am. What is your point?
My point is that this child is not just beautiful. This child is perfect in every single way. So why should you expect me as his mother to be without him for one second, let alone 2 weeks?
The tour was a resounding success, but as we see in the Netflix royal biopic, the beginnings of Diana mania are firmly established, causing Diana's husband Prince Charles to become jealous of her success and popularity.
Perth, fresh, alert, scrubbed by the sun, city of Australia's tomorrow.
According to the princess herself. But what was the real life story behind the 1983 Australia tour, and was Prince Charles actually jealous of his wife Diana? Did Princess Diana bring Prince William to Australia? Yes, a 9-month-old Prince William accompanied his parents on their royal 6-week tour of Australia and New Zealand in 1983. Diana is said to have refused to leave her infant son behind. Upon arrival in Alice Springs, Australia, Prince William, affectionately dubbed Billy the Kid by Australians, was carried down the steps of the Royal Australia Air Force Boeing 707 by his nanny, Barbara Barnes. The family posed for photographers before Barnes whisked William away to the couple's base at the farm in Woomergama, Albury, where Charles and Diana planned to rejoin him the following day.
He's doing quite well.
The couple's press secretary Victor Chapman told the press, "I heard Prince William cry only twice in 30 hours during the flight." Prince William's arrival at Woomergama coincided with the first rain the area had seen in 4 years, supporting the stereotype that royals have a knack of bringing on rain, as the press pointed out. The decision to bring William represented a marked break with tradition, contrasting with the Queen's visit to Australia in 1954. The Queen would never travel with Charles in case they both went down, and Charles was not supposed to travel with his new son, said Jane Connors, author of Royal Visits to Australia.
No interest in me! You refuse to come to Highgrove, where I'm happiest.
Yes, because she is there. Oh, and not just her, but the gardens and the...
Bringing William was what made it really different. There was a huge amount made of Diana being a breath of fresh air and so modern. It was enormous, via Guardian News 3. Was the royal tour in Australia a success? The princess who won the heart of Australia ran the Times headline in April 1983. Hailing the tour as an unqualified success, due in large part to the princess the tour saw Diana mania sweep across Australia and New Zealand. The couple attracted crowds of thousands. In Melbourne, for example, an estimated 200,000 people gathered to see the couple when Prince Charles officially opened the Bourke Street Mall.
My wife.
It was also estimated that the couple shook hands 2,000 times a day across the 6-week tour. And the words Princess Diana superimposed on top success and crowd turnout was compared to Queen Elizabeth II's 8-week tour in 1954.
Just remember, no touching, no looking.
To me or them.
Did Prince Charles become jealous of Princess Diana? During the Wales tour of Australia and New Zealand in 1983, Diana's global popularity became apparent to everyone, including her husband Prince Charles. Everyone always said when we were in the car, "Oh, we're on the wrong side, we want to see her, we don't want to see him," and obviously he wasn't used to that, and nor was I. How took it out on me? He was jealous, Diana said in an interview for Andrew Morton's biography. She continued, "I understood the jealousy, but I couldn't explain that I didn't ask for it." Australian politician John Kane later said, "The prince did indicate to me in one of the several discussions we had that people responded more warmly to his wife than they did to him."
Charles?
In Netflix's The Crown, Princess Anne warns the Queen. "You and I both know how much Charles craves reassurance and attention and praise. This tour of Australia and New Zealand was supposed to be his grand debut, his moment in the sun."
What's the problem? "You and I both know how much Charles craves reassurance and attention and praise. This tour of Australia and New Zealand was supposed to be his grand debut, his moment in the sun."
Did the Austin series? You wouldn't put a pig in charge of a herd of prime beef cattle, even if it did look good in a twinset and pearls. There's no online archival record of Hawk making those exact remarks, but he did indeed call Prince Charles a nice enough bloke. Hawk's Republican views were well known, and despite the success of Charles and Diana's tour, his party Labour still reduced Australia's ties with Britain by, for example, removing the visa. Hope you liked that video, and if you haven't subscribed this channel, do subscribe it, and we will see you in the next video.